Morning students, in the previous class we have seen the process of translation where in an orderly sequence based upon the sequences of mRNA, the order of amino acids and the sequence of amino acids in a protein molecule will be described, managed, identified, synthesized. So DNA is the main genetic material which is producing. The language of the DNA is transcribed into mRNA, and the language of mRNA in the form of codons is translated in the form of amino acids, and the sequence of amino acids, that particular sequence of amino acid determines a specific protein. So different proteins, different sequence of amino acids. Different sequences of amino acids is because of mRNA molecule. mRNA is because of DNA. So DNA is responsible for the formation of proteins indirectly. Directly, mRNA is responsible to take part in the process of translation. So this process of flow of information from the DNA to RNA to proteins is called central dogma of molecular biology. Central dogma of molecular biology. So central dogma of molecular biology is nothing but synthesis of proteins or protein synthesis. So after knowing, the next is gene expression or regulation of gene expression. So with the name regulation of gene expression, it consists of three different meanings, definitions, three different parts. First thing is, what is a gene? Second thing is, what is gene expression? Third thing is, what is meant by regulation of gene expression, or how gene expression is regulated? What is gene and what is gene expression and how gene expression is regulated? Regulation of gene expression or how a gene expression is, how the gene expression is regulated or what is meant by regulation . These are the various terms which are associated with the single heading. This topic, regulation of gene expression, is a broad term. So let us see them in a sequence. First, let us see what is gene. As we have studied, multicellular organisms, bodies are made up of many cells, and in every cell, different types of proteins are there. In every cell, different types of, and different cells, different types of proteins. So two statements. Various types of proteins are produced in the cells. So cells of the legs, cells of the hands, cells of the nose, cells of the ears, eyes, different proteins. First concept. In every cell is made up of so many proteins. It means different proteins are produced in every cell and in different cells. Then question comes, what is this proteins produced in different cells? As we have studied molecular biology, central dogma. Central dogma means DNA is responsible for mRNA and mRNA is responsible for proteins. Now, what is a gene? When we started studies, the definition of gene has been changed gradually from the times of Mendel. The father of Mendelism or principles of inheritance, Mendel considered a gene. According to Mendel, gene means it is a unit of inheritance. Unit of inheritance. And he considered this gene as element. So Mendel, he has not given the gene, but Mendel said that elements are units of inheritance. What is element? Gradually, element is the first name of gene. Element. Gradually it was converted, it was changed its definition, element to factor. What are factors? Factors are nothing but genes according to currents. The three scientists which rediscovered the Mendel's laws. Shermack, DeVries and Currens. Currens was that scientist. He has given the name factor to the element proposed by Mendel. What are these two? They were nothing but different names of the gene. Present day, we are going to call it as gene. Mendel's time, it was element, unit of inheritance. Unit of inheritance, which it will determine a character. Currens changed this element into factor, unit of inheritance. Factor gradually, in 1909, changed it to gene. So the term gene was given by Johansen in 1909. Johansen coined the term gene for the first time. So the definition of gene has been goes on changing based upon the research in the field of genetics, in the field of inheritance or heredity, a subject of science of genetics, gradually developing from the days of Mendel to the present day, which has taken its own dimensions of molecular biology, cytogenetics, genetics, applied genetics, genomics, proteomics, bioinformatics. Now, how the science of genetics has developed from the days of Mendel, which is called element, which is nothing but a gene. After that, factor is nothing but a gene. After that, the actual gene term was given by Johansen later. So, what is gene? Gene is nothing but after Johansen in the years 1927 to 50, they considered DNA is the genetic material. DNA is the genetic material. And then question comes, what is DNA? DNA is made up of deoxyribonucleotides. So many deoxyribonucleotides are present. Each and every deoxyribonucleotides are nothing but maybe genes. So where are these genes? Genes are nothing but any nucleotide sequence of DNA. Any nucleotide sequence of DNA. is considered as gene. So Mendel's elements, factors, gene, so-called deoxyribonucleotides are the sequences of DNA. Any part of the DNA is considered as gene. It means in the DNA so many genes are present. And what are these genes? These genes are responsible for various cell types. Within a single cell also so many genes are responsible for so many proteins. Now gene means after the discovery of double helix structure of DNA and as per the modern definitions of gene, modern forms of gene has provided information by Seymour Benzer coined the term cistron. So cistron is a modified name term for the gene. Element, second, third, sequences, any sequence of the DNA is called cistron, which codes for a particular specific polypeptide or protein. So Seymour Benzer, he has coined the term cistron or a structural unit in the DNA. Cistron, a cistron is nothing but that area of DNA which will produce an mRNA. This mRNA in turn produce amino acid sequences in the form of a protein. So which part of the DNA is called cistron? The part of the DNA which has a gene, which is called cistron, and that gene is responsible to produce one polypeptide chain. What is a polypeptide chain? A protein. What is a protein? It may be a structural protein, it may be a biochemical protein, hormonal protein, it may be a enzymatic protein. So in the body of organisms, when genes are expressed, so here cistron is that term to the gene which can be defined as a gene is nothing but a cistron which will produce one polypeptide chain. So whenever a gene is producing a character, this is called gene expression. What character will gene express? Gene express means gene, a phenotypic character it will express. At molecular level, a gene in our body is nothing but DNA sequence. The DNA sequence will form a cistron and cistron will form a protein. It means gene is expressed in the form of protein. A gene is expressed in the form of protein. Or so many other genes are there. All our genes are not cistrons. They are responsible for tRNA formation. Some are responsible for RNA formation. Some are responsible for some other metabolic activity, some other enzyme, some other various types of functions gene is having in the body of the organisms. And see here, later Benzer has defined some other names to the gene. They are called recon, RECON, unit of recombination, structural unit, formation of a protein, unit of recombination. What is recombination? We have studied recombination in the meiosis, where in meiosis 1, during leptotene formation of chromosome, zygotene pairing of chromosome, in between the pairs of chromosome, during pachytene crossing over means recombinations, recombines. So any part of the DNA which is capable to show recombination is called recon. It is another name of gene. So a gene can be considered as an element, factor, or gene, or nucleotide sequence in the DNA, either in the form of cistern or recon, or another modern form, muton. Unit of mutation. So in the DNA sequences, we have seen during genetic code and mutation. Genetic code is nothing but the sequences of DNA and mRNA and amino acids. If any change in the DNA sequence, will change the mRNA and change the amino. Why? Because that changing unit is called a muton. It is nothing but gene. So the modern names of genes are cistern, recon, and muton, whereas old names of gene are element, factor. Then finally, what a gene is? A gene is nothing but the sequences of DNA which are responsible to produce a phenotypic character, or if, for example, this human being is black in color, this much of in height, this much of in length, width, these are his structural qualities, the distance of the finger, length of the hand, elbow, eyes, visual capacity of the eyes, hearing capacity, listening and understanding capacity, all these are characters. All these are characters are because of the genes. If a character is present in an organism, means gene is expressed. Gene expression, what is gene? We have seen. So the definition of gene is goes on changing. Olden days, when we are having less knowledge, the gene definition is less. When the changes, our knowledge regarding the subject has been increased. So it has taken various changes, and presently we can call a gene as a cistern or recon or muton, or in a generalized sense, the sequences of the DNA which can represent a character. What type of characters proteins represent? So many structural proteins are there, enzymatic proteins are there, bio molecule proteins are there, biochemical proteins are there. They are responsible for various hormones, various types of even skin, hairs, keratin, pigment, various types of proteins are nothing but because of the gene structure. So whenever in an organism a character is present, means that particular gene is expressed. So whenever a gene is expressed, whenever a gene is produced, a gene is said to be in the DNA, and it will produce mRNA, and mRNA will produce a protein by translation. It means the gene in the DNA is expressed. This is called gene expression. When a particular sequence of N2 bases in DNA by central dogma or molecular biology definition or protein synthesis, bases in DNA express a character or a trait. Trait is nothing but character in the form of a protein, or in the form of enzyme, or in the form of a function. Gene expression means when a particular sequence of N2 bases of DNA or in the DNA are expressed a character or trait. How express means? By central dogma, that is, DNA has to produce mRNA, mRNA has to produce amino acids. Those amino acids togetherly constitutes one protein or many proteins. Express a character or a trait in the form of a protein or enzyme. This process is called gene expression. So gene definition we have completed. Gene expression we have completed. Now, थर्ड कॉन्सेप्ट रेगुलेशन ऑफ जीन एक्सप्रेशन. रेगुलेशन ऑफ जीन एक्सप्रेशन. लिसन माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट. जीन वी हैव सीन इन द डीएनए एंड जीन एक्सप्रेशन मीन्स ए कैरेक्टर. एंड व्हेन जीन्स आर प्रेजेंट इन एन ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्रॉम इट्स जाइगोटिक कंडीशन, एम्ब्रियोनिक कंडीशंस, एंड जीन एक्सप्रेशन इज so many genes. For example, this is a human body. My body is a human body which is in front of you, and it is having so many characters. Now my body is called adult body, and whatever genes are present in my body, they were present in my body from my childhood, from my embryonic stages. And my embryo, when I was in the form of a zygote, or becomes by cell division, so many cells increase, it becomes embryo, and embryo undergoes differentiation to get parts. Differentiation means having legs, limbs, hind limbs are, fore limbs are, various parts are differentiated. During this differentiation, so here question comes, how this differentiation of various parts and various genes present in my embryonic conditions, which are there in my embryonic condition in my DNA. And here regulation means first concept, so many genes are present in the DNA, but all these genes will not express all of a sudden at a time. All the genes will not express at a time, and genes will express based upon the growth of that organism. When the organism is growing slowly, gradually, various genes will express their characters in the form of characters, express themselves in the form of characters. And that genes which are expressing in an adult organism, the proteins which are synthesizing in an adult organism are not synthesized in an embryonic condition. And the proteins which are synthesized in the embryonic condition, they were not synthesized in the adult organism. It means in the body of in an organism's body, various cells are having accurate programmed mechanism, already defined mechanism. So at this stage, 5 years old, these are the genes they have to be expressed. At 10 years old, these are the genes they have to be expressed. At 15 years, these are the genes they have to express. At 20 years, adult, young, these are the genes to be expressed. At a middle age, old age, so the developmental process of an organism, different genes will express at different times. Now question comes, why this is so? This is because genes are under the control of some other genes. Our genes are regulated. A 5 years boy has to show these genes. The remaining genes which are present in his body are regulated in such a way they are not to express at 5 years stage. And when a 5 years back becomes 10 years old, some other genes will be expressed. The genes which are not supposed to express, they will not be expressed. It is called gene regulation. For example, in my body, this is my character of having mustache, or my nose of this length, or my ears of this, my seeing ability of watching or understanding or teaching, all are my characters. For example, best identified easily, my mustache are because of I am a male gender. My male character is present from my embryonic condition when I was born as a child. I am a male baby, boy, and gradually boy is growing, and genes for my mustaches are present in my body in my childhood, but they are regulated. They were regulated at the age of 5 years or 10 years. My genes for my mustaches are not expressed. So at the age of 5 or 10 or 12 years, I am not going to get mustaches. Only certain period enters, certain food material or protein or hormonal protein is responsible for the development of mustaches. Until then, my genes for my mustaches are in control, under regulation. This is called gene regulation. It means so many genes are present in the DNA and all the genes will not express at a time. What is the reason for not expressing at a time? Because they were under the control of some other genes. Several genes are formed as a unit called regulation. So at a particular stage, this character has to be developed. For example, in the girls, secondary sexual character, a girl and boy in the starting, both are same. Even their voice also same, body parts also same. Gradually, when they were developed, secondary sexual character, length of the hairs, secondary characters of body development, maturity period, menstrual cycle formation, mustache formation, change in the voice of a boy, his voice different, girl voice is different. All these are changes. So all these changes are coordinated and controlled. This coordinated control activity of genes is called regulation. So when a gene has to express, or which gene has to express at which time, and which gene does not express at that time. Does not expressing gene may express some other time, or which time a gene has to express is under regulation, under control. This is called regulation of gene expression. So how the gene expression is regulated? A gene has to express, for example, DNA is a genetic material having sequences. It will produce by transcription mRNA, which is nothing but the sequences of DNA transcribed. And mRNA, by a process called translation, produces a protein. What is this protein? This protein may be a structural protein. Structural protein. It will form a structure. It may be a biochemical protein, which may form a biochemical hormones. It may be a enzymatic protein. Enzymatic protein means various metabolic activities are there. For every metabolic activity, enzyme is required. Without enzyme, that metabolic activity will not occur. So various metabolic activities, various types of enzymes are required by the organism, by one cell and many cells. So for every enzyme, the enzyme is nothing but all enzymes are proteins. And protein definitely has to come from the mRNA. And mRNA should come from the DNA. This is what? Central dogma of molecular biology. It means if genes are present on the DNA, maybe in the form of elements, factors, sequences, or cistron, or recon, or muton, they have to produce mRNA, they have to produce a protein. It means genes are expressed. So gene expression. And when a gene has to express, when gene does not express, is called regulation of gene expression. Regulation means control. Now, to understand this regulation of gene expression, our scientists studied and they have defined gene expression, or expression of a gene, can be regulated at various levels. Again, question. A gene has to express means what it has to do? It has to show transcription. So transcription, unless DNA will transcribe, mRNA will not produce. So this is the level of gene regulation. If any regulation control is there, it may allow the gene to express, to undergo mRNA, or it may not allow. So gene regulation, or regulation of gene expression, is at transcription level. Here it may allow the gene to transcribe, or it may not allow the gene to transcribe. Second level is, after the transcription, mRNA has to undergo processing. So processing is found only in eukaryotes. Processing of mRNA to become functional. At this level also, it may allow the mRNA to undergo processing, or it may stop the mRNA to undergo processing. It means at various levels, gene expression is regulated. At various levels, gene expression is regulated, controlled. And after processing, mRNA has to move from the nucleus into the cytoplasm. mRNA moves out of nucleus, moving out of the nucleus into cytoplasm. So if gene has to express means, first it has to undergo transcription to become mRNA. A gene has to undergo processing to become functional mRNA. A gene has to undergo, that mRNA has to go out of the nucleus into the cytoplasm for translation. Fourth one, after entering into cytoplasm, it has to undergo translation. So, in eukaryotes, there are four levels. Where gene expression can be regulated. First paragraph in the NCERT textbook, they have given first sentence, regulation of gene expression is a broad term to define. Then they have given the second sentence, if gene is producing a protein is nothing but expression of a gene for a polypeptide or a protein. For this, it has to undergo transcription and translation and various steps. In eukaryotes, regulation of gene expression occurs at any of these four levels. In the textbook, first paragraph, at a transcription level, again I am repeating, regulation of gene expression or control of gene expression at transcription level means, in some, they may allow the DNA to become mRNA, or they may not allow the. So it is controlled here or regulated here at transcriptional level. So gene expression at a transcription level controlled or regulated. Second, gene expression is regulated at processing level. Processing of mRNA, it occurs only in eukaryotes after the formation of RNA, which is called heterogeneous nuclear RNA. Three types of steps: processing, capping, tailing, and splicing. All this has to occur, then only it will go out for a further process. But it may allow or may not allow. So that level of gene regulation is processing level. Next, after processing, mRNA has to move from the nucleus into the cytoplasm to show translation. But gene regulation here is, it may allow the process or it may not allow the process, which is called the level of gene expression where it is controlled. And finally, in the translation, if it allows, translation will occur and gene will express, or it will does not allow, translation will not occur, gene expression will be stopped. It means regulation of gene expression at a transcriptional level, processing level, movement of nucleus to the cytoplasm, or translation. Next paragraph of the textbook. So my dear students, with this we are able to identify what is a gene, first character, then what is meant by gene expression, then what is gene regulation. Here gene regulation means not gene, gene expression is regulated, regulation of gene expression. At which level? Various levels. Now let us see with an example of Escherichia coli bacteria, where gene expression is studied carefully and where gene regulation of gene expression is studied. For example, Escherichia coli bacteria, able to show metabolism of lactose. It shows lactose metabolism. Metabolism means synthesis, breakdown, anabolism or catabolism. Here catabolism it indicates. What is meant by lactose metabolism in Escherichia coli bacteria? See here. Escherichia coli bacteria, when milk is present, if milk is available to bacteria, most important concept, if milk is available to bacteria, this bacteria produces beta galactosidase enzyme. Beta galactosidase enzyme. This beta galactosidase enzyme acts on lactose. What is lactose? When bacteria is having milk, from the milk bacteria will take the lactose. That is the concept. From the milk bacteria will take lactose, and this lactose, the beta galactosidase produced by the E. coli, what it will do? It will break the lactose into two. Split the lactose, break the lactose, catabolize the lactose, glucose and galactose. Glucose and breakdown of lactose. Catabolism of lactose. Lactose is broken down by the activity of enzyme to produce glucose and galactose, which are energy source, energy to the bacteria. Energy. So the bacteria will take glucose or galactose as energy for its growth, for its development, for its life, for its survival. Again, bacteria, the process of breakdown of lactose into glucose and galactose is called lactose metabolism. What is lactose metabolism? The process of breakdown of lactose into glucose and galactose is called lactose metabolism. How it is? E. coli bacteria will produce enzyme. Question, my dear students, when E. coli bacteria produce enzyme, when E. coli bacteria is present in milk and it is getting lactose, why this enzyme has to break the lactose into? So if E. coli bacteria is not having milk or no lactose, it is not going to synthesize enzyme. So it is nothing but a control, a regulation. Whenever Escherichia coli bacteria is having availability of lactose, it has to break the lactose into glucose and galactose as its energy. If lactose is not there, it is not going to produce the enzyme. So what is enzyme? Is nothing but protein. Protein synthesis. So the expression of the gene of production of beta galactosidase is controlled. So E. coli bacteria has to break down the lactose. Again, this breakdown of lactose into two is by beta galactosidase enzyme. It has to produce by the DNA of the E. coli, produce mRNA. mRNA has to produce protein, enzyme, nothing but beta galactosidase. When it is producing transcription mRNA, translation protein or enzyme. Enzymes are nothing but, so the gene of the E. coli is expressed. The gene of the E. coli is expressed when it forms a protein. When it is expressed, when lactose is there to break the lactose into two, it is expressed. If lactose is not there, the gene is present in the E. coli but will not express. It will not, there is no need. There is no need of production of enzyme. So the genes for the expression of beta galactosidase enzyme is regulated or under control. When to express, when not to express. It is beautifully studied. So gene regulation or regulation of gene expression means, in the second paragraph of gene regulation they have given, it is metabolic, physiological and environmental . So direct APMT old question, they may ask in the NEET examination, direct textbook, cut and paste. It is nothing but, what is regulation of gene expression? Regulation is nothing but metabolic, physiological and environmental factors that control whether a gene has to express or not to express. Whenever a cell needs, based upon the requirement of this need of the cell, need of the cell is to break the lactose. If there is no need of breaking lactose, no expression. So it is a metabolic. And metabolic activity is nothing but physiological character. Physiological character is nothing but environmental character. The environment where E. coli is there, milk should be there. From the milk, it has to get lactose. So metabolic, physiological and environmental factors that controls the regulation of gene expression. Beautifully defined in the textbook. Again, it has to produce, break the lactose to get energy. It has to produce enzyme. If there is no lactose, no need of enzyme production. Simple. In the second paragraph of textbook, they explain this part. And in eukaryotes at 4 levels, regulation of gene expression. In prokaryotes, regulation of gene expression is at transcriptional level. Is predominant. Textbook Straight question. Predominant means mainly. In prokaryotes, regulation of gene expression. In eukaryotes, at any four levels they have given. At a transcription, or at a processing, or movement of mRNA from nucleus to cytoplasm, or translational. But in prokaryotes, the regulation of gene expression is mainly, predominantly at transcriptional level, that too, especially during initiation of transcription. During initiation of transcription. Unless you have some earlier knowledge of what is transcription, initiation of transcription, you cannot go further from this point. Because it is somehow a complex one. The student has to have some memory capacity of our previous classes. Transcription, for example, regulation of gene expression at transcriptional level, especially regulation of gene initiation of transcription. What is meant by initiation of transcription? I think this character might have entered into your mind. Again, we have to go to transcription. Already we have seen so many times transcription. This is the DNA molecule, and the DNA molecule at a particular place, promoter, structural gene, terminator. These two areas, in between the two areas, which is called structural gene. Structural gene, which is called transcriptional unit. Unit of transcription. Here, in this, what actual process happens? DNA out of the two strands, at a particular area, at a particular point, it will unwind with the help of polymerase, RNA polymerase enzyme, DNA dependent RNA polymerase enzyme. It does not require any promoter. It does not require any primer. Out of the two strand, one strand act as template, other strand is coding strand. So it has to catch promoter site where three different regions are there for the binding of the enzyme, recognition of the enzyme, and initiation of the process of transcription. At this place, binding of enzyme, what enzyme? RNA polymerase. Recognition sequences which recognize and initiation sequences. Binding sequences of enzyme. Binding sequences. Recognition sequences. What are these? This is the area where DNA dependent RNA polymerase will come and bind. Where it will bind? A recognition sequence. After binding, what happens? Some initiation sequences with the help of sigma factor, it transcribes mRNA. That is the process. But here, later, sigma factor will go out. RNA polymerase is responsible for elongation factors at a particular area, termination factors. The synthesis of mRNA stops. And nascent mRNA molecule, which is a heterogeneous nuclear in eukaryotes, whereas normal RNA without any processing comes out in prokaryotes. Now, regulation of gene expression at a transcriptional level in prokaryotes means expression of regulation of gene expression at a transcriptional level, especially initiation of transcription, means it is controlled, regulated. It means the DNA dependent RNA polymerase molecule it fails to identify the initiation sequences. This is called regulation of gene expression. It means if it fails to recognize the initiation sequences, DNA will not bind to promoter, the transcription process of mRNA will not starts. There is no mRNA. If there is no mRNA, the gene or cystone is not going to express. So gene expression is controlled or stopped in prokaryotes, especially during initiation of transcription, regulation of gene expression. So gene expression is regulated. This part, initiation of sequences, RNA polymerase fails to identify. It means the process of gene expression. So this gene has to express by transcription and translation. The process of gene expression is controlled or regulated at a transcriptional level, that too initiation of transcriptional level. Now to explain this process, two scientists, they worked on Escherichia coli and they have identified this is because of the regulation of gene expression is because of a group of genes which are called operon. A group of genes are a regulation unit of a particular gene is regulated. That total number of genes included in that regulated unit, regulation unit, is called operon, or simply a regulation unit of a gene. And this operon regarding the lactose metabolism in E. coli, this operon is regarding lactose metabolism in Escherichia coli. So it is called lactoperon concept, lactoperon model, lactoperon model of regulation of gene expression, lactoperon model of regulation of gene expression. What is gene we have studied? What is gene expression we have studied? We have seen what is expression means. And what is regulation we have studied? For the detailed information regarding the regulation, regulation in simple, it is called a process of control, regulated, maybe faster, maybe slower, or maybe like a accelerator, control, which will, there are three optimal points. It may be more, it may be medium, lesser, it may be average, optimum. This is called regulation. Here, regulation of gene expression is not like this, but it is fixed. How it is going to show regulation of gene? This is to understand DNA to mRNA. After that, mRNA into protein is called translation. But in bacteria, here itself, regulation is studied. So it is compulsory to understand transcriptional unit. Now, lactoperon concept. Lactoperon lactoferrin concept. First studied by Jacob and Monod 1961, received Nobel Prize 65. So we'll study the process in the coming classes. Wish you all the best.